My dear students, assalamu alaikum to all of you. I hope that you all are doing good. Well, this is your English teacher Ms. Javeria with another interesting grammar topic today. My dear students, today we are going to study about the usage of was and were. At first, we have to know and we have to understand the difference between was and were. That where do we have to use was? In what cases do we have to use was? And in what cases we have to use were. So look at the board carefully and understand this thing first. Dear students, whenever we talk about I, he, she, it or any singular noun. Now what is singular noun? Do you know the meanings of singular? Singular means one. For example, this is one marker, so this marker is singular. If I have two markers here, then it will become plural. So singular means one. Anything that is one is called singular. And what does noun means? Noun is a name of anything. So singular noun means any noun that is one. For example, Ahmed is a noun, pen is a noun, desk is a noun, this board is a noun, light is a noun. Anything that is noun and that is one, so it will become as singular noun. So my dear students, whenever in sentences we use I, he, she, it or any singular noun, so what do we have to use with these things, with these pronouns and nouns? We are going to use was. All right, this was has to be used in these things: I, he, she, it or any singular noun. And whenever we talk about you, we, they or any plural noun. Now in the same way, what does plural mean? Anything that is more than one. For example, two markers, two boards, two sentences. Anything that is more than one is called plural. It can be two or it can be more than two, up to 100, up to 1000, it will become as plural. And noun means name of anything. For example, in this case I gave you the example for singular noun, Ahmed. If we talk about plural, so it can become Ahmed and Ali. All right, so noun becomes two and it will become plural. So dear students, whenever we talk about you, we, they or any plural noun, so what do we have to use? This were. Now you have understand the difference in between these two, in these two cases: I, he, she, it singular noun, was, you, we, they plural noun, were. Keep remember these two things so that when you're going to translate this thing, it will become easy for you. All right, now we are moving towards the translation, but you have to keep one thing in your mind that this was were belongs to the past tense. Anything that has happened, anything that has gone is called past tense. So whenever we talk about past tense, whenever we have to make the sentences in the past tense, this was were is must. So the first tense translation that we are going to start is number one, ladka udaas tha, boy. Now this boy, you tell me, this boy, is it singular or plural? I have just explained you that whenever we talk about one thing, any one noun, boy is a noun and we are talking about just one boy. We are not talking about boys. So in this case, what do we have to use? We have to use this was. Boy was. And what is the translation of udaas? It will become sad. Boy was sad. Number two, sher bhooka tha. In the same way, line. Here we are talking about only one singular noun. So what do we have to use? Was or were? We are going to use this was here. Lion was hungry. Number three, tum wahan the. Now in this case, you have one exceptional case here. Here you might imagine or you might think that you is also singular. Because tum, hum ek insaan ki baat kar rahe hain, tum is a singular. But according to the grammatical rule, whenever we talk about you, so we have to apply all the singular rules here. We do not apply any kind of singular rule with this you in every kind of tense. So we will write it here. What was? No, we are going to write were. You were there. Do remember this thing that whenever, in every sentence, whenever we use this you, you have to apply the plural noun, plural rule with this you. Never apply the singular rule. Wo khel rahe the, they. Now here with this they, this is a singular pronoun. So we will use were. They were playing. Barish ho rahi thi. It was raining. Barish, here barish is also a singular thing. So we have used was here. Now my dear students, let's repeat this translation once again with me. Ladka udaas tha. Boy was sad. Sher bhooka tha. Lion was hungry. Tum wahan the. You were there. Wo khel rahe the. They were playing. Barish ho rahi thi. It was raining. So always what you have to remember, you have to remember the difference and the usage of was and were. That in what cases you have to use was, in what cases you have to use were. If you remember this thing, if you remember your singular and your plural nouns, then translation is no more difficult for you. We have one more exercise from the same chapter that we started in the previous part, part 1. That is unit number 13, what a noise. Here we have some words, some sentences here related to that chapter. The chapter was Mr. Majid had a music shop. So here we have some sentences and some words are given here. We have to put these words in the correct sentences. So at first, I'm going to read out these words. These are played, came, went, ran, walked, and got. These all words are related to the past tense. If we convert in the present tense, so it will become played, play, came, come, went, go, ran, run, walked, walk, got. Now, my dear students, let's start solving these sentences. The first one is lots of people dash into Mr. Majid's shop. So we have to read out the words and then we have to put the correct word here. Lots of people played into Mr. Majid's shop? No. They went? No. Did they ran? Did they walk? Did they got something? No. What did they do? They came into Mr. Majid's shop. So we have written here as came. Lots of people came into Mr. Majid's shop. There was a woman, a boy, some man who came into Mr. Majid's shop. Let's move towards the next sentence. They dashed the piano, trumpet, cymbals, and drums. Do you remember when I explained you the chapter, I told you about particularly that the woman played something, the boy played something. So here what do we have to write this? Played. They played the piano, trumpet, cymbal, and drums. Let's move towards the third sentence. Mr. Majid dashed out of his shop. Do you remember that Mr. Majid got so much exhausted by the noises of the shop, the noises of the musical instruments? So what did he do? He ran out of his shop. Now the next sentence is he dashed on a train. When he left his shop, so he directly got on a train and he went somewhere. So what do we have to write here? Got. He got on a train. Number 5, he dashed into a big field. What did he do? When he left his shop, at first he went into a farm and then he walked into a big field. And the last sentence is, then he dashed to sleep. When he got into the big field, what did he do? The environment was quiet, the environment was calm. So he went to sleep. So my dear students, these all sentences were related to this chapter, unit number 13, what a noise. And in these sentences, we have used these verbs. Basically, these are all verbs. Verb is doing action. Any action is called verb. For example, playing, jumping, laughing, walking, eating, running. These all things are called verb. So these are all verbs, but they are in the past tense. Played, came, went, ran, walked, and got. So my dear student, that was all from my today's lesson. Today we have studied about the usage of was and were. And today we have completed one exercise from unit number 13. I hope that you have enjoyed my today's lesson. I will catch you next week inshallah with another lesson. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz. Goodbye.